know.
Yeah, that's what those pseudo Israelites, those false Israelites, okay? Which means that they don't have the right clothes on. They don't have the truth. All right. Went over there in the land of Israel. They're not lifting up a banner against the so-called Jews, okay? Because they recently became citizens. And when you become a citizen, you have to fight in the Israeli army. So that means you join yourself to the so-called white man. You join yourself to the devil. Alright? We're not supposed to be yoked with the so-called white man. Alright?
It says, I have commanded my sanctified ones. I have also called my mighty ones before mine anger, even them that rejoice in my highness. Noise of a multitude in the mountains, like as of a great people, a tumultuous noise of the kingdoms of the nations gathered together, the Lord of hosts mustered the host of the battle.
Yeah, those guys that are in the land of Israel right now, Ben-Amin, whatever the hell his name is, all right, he's not teaching Israel that the so-called white man's the devil, okay? He's not teaching the Israel that the so-called Jews are the devil. They're crackers too, okay? They're crackers too, all right? They got a tan for being in the sun, alright? They're crackers, they're the devil, alright? The guy he teaches it because he's a false prophet. He's not of the Lord, he's not of the Lord's elect. Right.
Revelation 3:9. I know thy works in tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich.
Synagogue of Satan, okay? So that's referring to impossible. You know, people that say that they keep the law and they really don't. Even people that impersonate our culture, our laws, statutes, commandments, even some of our physical features, alright? So-called Jews, alright? They're not the biblical Israelites, alright? And what that guy did that went over to the land of Israel, he joined himself and the people that he took with him with the so-called white man. Alright? We're not supposed to be yoked with the devil. Alright? We're supposed to be pure. The Lord sanctified Israel and made us separate from the rest of the nation.
Just real quick, this is 1 Timothy 4:1 about false prophets. It says, now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits.
And that was a seducing spirit, okay? Meaning a demon, a devil. That made that guy go over to the land of Israel, okay?
Right.
He was fulfilling prophecy, or he could escape the curses somehow. Alright? Right? That's what he had in his mind.
Says, giving heed.
Because we're cursed here, you know. The last hire, the first fire. We're oppressed in America. So he probably had a thought in his head that maybe he had better opportunities for him and his people over there in that land.
Yeah,
and they're still catching hell over there.
Yeah, but the law, the curses that are amongst us aren't restricted to regions, alright? They're gonna be on us until the Lord literally takes them off of us. Alright? And that's when he brings his kingdom down to the ground. Lifting up that curse as you speak, because now the truth's out there. And that's what we're teaching. It says, speaking lies, it's like, it says, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils, speaking lies and hypocrisy, having their conscience seared with a hot iron.
So the point is that it was never commanded us, okay, by the Lord, by any prophet, for men to lead other men back to our own land, the land of Israel, okay? Because right now, the heathen are dwelling in that land, all right? Our job, the heathen, okay, meaning the other nations, okay? People that dwell outside our nation, all right? That are not Israelites. That's what I mean by heathen in this respect, all right?
So who's going to take that land to Israel?
The Lord's going to return us to the land. The Lord's going to return us to the land.
They
get
ready to be a war with
Iran. Yeah, well, after all that shit is marked up, after the Lord pronounces his judgment on this land, burns America completely with fire, burns the land of Israel with fire, got the sign for you right there, alright? That's the Lord's judgment right there, alright? So if you're not sealed, okay? If you're not sealed among the elect, then all flesh and all God, which the Lord is the Most High and the Son, you're going to be marked up like that. That fire is going to burn you up. You don't get yourself in order. All right, and the Lord don't have mercy on you.
But I read the Bible and the angels, and they questioned the angels. I'm just not getting into this stuff now. And the angels questioned the angels, saying, who are those that have washed their robes white as snow? And the angels said to them, he said, they are those
Telling the angels, okay, to hold back the fire, okay? That's what you're going to destroy. We're talking about fire from missiles, okay? Fire from nuclear missiles. That's the fire, okay? That's what the Lord's telling the angels to hold back. The Lord's fire, okay?
But what is the wildfire burning up all this shit?
Well, the scriptures tell you that the fire is going to be already on the earth, all right? The scriptures say there's always going to be fires on the earth. The Lord's the one that starts fires, all right?
Through his angels?
Through his angels,
man. Y'all, reach them up. Keep going. Keep going. Start reading. I'm going to start reading.
Done.
Y'all need to go, man.
No, they're going to go. They're going.